Peace, family. This is Lion's Den with another news and commentary. I have some good news to tell you guys. Some really, really, really good news. A Philadelphia judge grants new appeal to cop killer Mumia Abdul-Jabbar. Now, for those of you who don't know who he is, he was a man that was convicted in 1981 for killing a Philadelphia police officer. And he maintained his innocence since then. He's tried appeals to get a new trial. Unfortunately, they keep shutting him down, keep denying getting new appeals. Well, finally, he finally got a new appeal. And this article is according to Raw Story. A Philadelphia judge has allowed convicted police killer Mumia Abdul-Jabbar to launch a new appeal, ruling that a former Chief Justice of the Pennsylvania Supreme Court should have recused himself from the inmate's previous appeals. Abdul-Jabbar, 64, a former black nationalist and public radio reporter, was sentenced to death for the 1981 killing of Philadelphia police officer Daniel Faulkner. His sentence was commuted to life without parole in 2011. Judge Leon W. Tucker said former Chief Justice Ronald Castile should have stepped aside because his past service as Philadelphia District Attorney, the office which prosecuted Abdul-Jabbar, created an appearance of bias. True justice must be completely just without even a hint of partiality, lack of integrity, or impropriety. Tucker wrote in his opinion issued late on Thursday, petitioner is entitled to an unbiased tribunal without even the appearance of impropriety. Lawyer for Abdul-Jabbar now have 30 days to begin a new appeal, which will first be heard by the Pennsylvania Supreme Court, Superior Court, and then, if necessary, by the Supreme Court. Castile, who could not be reached for comment on Friday, retired in 2014. Four new justices have joined the seven-member high court since Abdul-Jabbar's last appeal was denied in 2012. Abdul-Jabbar, a past president of the Philadelphia Association of Black Journalists, sought permission for a new appeal after the U.S. Supreme Court ruled in 2016 that Castile's refusal to recuse himself from an appeal of a different death penalty case created an impermissible risk of bias. Tucker said Abdul-Jabbar was unable to prove Castile's direct involvement in his prosecution and death sentence. He was then an assistant district attorney, but noted Castile campaigned for the Supreme Court in 1993, touting the numbers of defendants he sent to death row. This was a straightforward application of federal and Pennsylvania law requires cases to decide by judges whose impartiality cannot reasonably be questioned, said Judith Ritter, one of Abdul-Jabbar's attorneys. Dustin Slaughter, a spokesman for the Philadelphia District Attorney's Office, said they are examining the ruling and have not yet decided whether to appeal. Abdul-Jabbar was once described by the New York Times as the world's best-known death row inmate. Tucker called his case one of the most polarized criminal cases in Philadelphia history, the nation, and perhaps worldwide. Maureen Faulkner, the officer's widow, was removed from Tucker's courtroom in October after an outburst during the hearings that preceded his ruling. So this is really, really good news, ladies and gentlemen. You know, this case has, they've been waiting for years to get an appeal. And now Mumia Abdul-Jabbar will get his appeal. As you may know, this guy, Ronald Castile, who was a former Chief Justice, should have recused himself years ago, but refused to. And he's been showing bias against Mumia Abdul-Jabbar since then. So, you know, the good news is that basically, at first they would sentence him to death, and then they changed his sentence in 2011 for life without parole. And ever since then, he's keep fighting for appeals that didn't come until this year. So I'm happy that now, hopefully, thanks to this new appeal, they can finally get a new trial for Mumia Abdul-Jabbar. Hopefully that has new evidence that clear this guy. So I'm so glad that the Philadelphia criminal justice system is finally give Mumia Abdul-Jabbar chance to defend himself and plead his innocence after all these years. So I'm glad this is happening. Leave a comment. Tell me what you think about this article. Share this video. Subscribe my YouTube channel. Subscribe my reaction channel. And subscribe my Black Junction channel for all the news and commentary. With that being said, this is Lion's Den signing off. Deuces.